In this video, we're going to have a look at our alert log and how to get them, set them up, prioritize them, everything that you need to keep yourself at peak efficiency. So let's get started. Let's talk about this layout first. The top window is the chart of the US CAD, but these alerts will work regardless of what instrument you're using or what market you're trading. Then we have three windows at the bottom. So going from the left is the control center so that we can manage our workspaces. The market analyzer is going to be our workhorse for scanning the patterns in the middle. And the alert log is going to be on the far right, which is what we're gonna use to populate a list of all the alerts as they come out. So you can get to each one of these windows by using the control center under the new menu and then opening up the market analyzer and the alert log. First, I'm gonna keep this simple. We're gonna show you an example and then you can probably build on this. So let's take a simple condition like using an RSI, and we wanna say if it crossed over an overbought or an oversold zone on a 5-minute time frame, we're gonna get alert for that. I don't use RSI, I'm just using this as a simple example that you can then base your own alerts off of. Okay, first things first, we need to configure your market analyzer to include RSI. So right click and go to columns and then double click on indicators, and that's gonna add to the list. Now, once we've done that, we have to tell it which indicator we want to use. So we're gonna select RSI. We're also going to change the time frame here from 1 minute to 5 minutes, since that was the requirement we originally set out. And we're also going to remove the bid and the ask price, since I'm really only interested in knowing what the last price is and not the bid and the ask. So we're going to press OK, and our market analyzer now has another column called RSI on the 60-minute time frame. Now we're going to populate the market analyzer with all the markets that we want to scan. I'm going to right click on the market analyzer and go to add instruments. I'm going to pick my Forex list. You'll see all the pairs I've added get listed in my market analyzer. And if you want to know how to configure instrument lists or create your own, I'm going to put a link to that video that we did in the description below. Now we can see all the values of RSI listed in the market analyzer for each pair. We're now going to say that if RSI is above 70, we want to turn that cell green. And if it's below 30, we want to turn it red. We also want to throw an alert into our alert log that will appear red or green as well. So how do we do this? So right click on the market analyzer and go to columns again. Select the column for the indicator, the RSI indicator, and scroll all the way down to the bottom and you'll see a field called conditions. So if we put our mouse over that field, it will give you the option to edit the conditions. So we'll just go ahead and select this, and in the bottom left, it will say add. After you click add, you're gonna be given a little window here where you can configure all your sell conditions. So remember, green is going to be above 70, and we'll do that first. So I'm gonna change the background color to green and the foreground color to white, so it's easy to read. In the text, I'm gonna leave this empty since I want the actual RSI value in there. I don't wanna replace the text with anything. So I'm gonna leave that blank, and then I'm gonna click OK, and we're done. So let's do the same thing, and we're gonna go and say if we're below 30, we're gonna turn the cell red, and then we're done with step one, which is coloring the cells. Now right click on the market analyzer and go to alerts. Okay, so we're now gonna throw an alert into the alert log. So click the add button and then change the name to RSI 5-minute red. The name is just gonna be a reference point, so you can call it whatever you want. Underneath conditions, we're now gonna pick add and then say numerical value is less than the numerical value of 30. Press okay, and underneath the message, we're gonna turn the background color red and the foreground color white. Okay, we're now going to add in the action for the audio alert, and we're gonna show a pop-up box. And now we're gonna do the same thing if we go over 70. You can start to see that alert window populating now. The newest alerts should be by default at the top, but you wanna watch that date field and just select it so that it will resort it so that you do get the most recent alerts at the top of the alert log. So this is obviously a great way to free up your time so you're not always chained to your desk, and I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial video. If you have any questions about it, head over to our website, xabcdtrading.com, and we'll definitely help you out. There's a little button there for the live chat in the bottom left, or the bottom right, I believe it is now, and you will be able to see that and click on it and ask for any assistance, or feel free, if it's any easier, to toss a comment in the box below, and we can definitely try and help you out there as well. So don't forget to subscribe, and I would appreciate that. If you could give this video a big thumbs up if you learned something as well. Also, feel free to get our Priceline tool, absolutely free, and our news indicator tool, which are great for a couple of NTA tools that everyone could probably use. So I'll see you guys in the next video, and until then, take care.